Welcome to Average Joe's Gym's Home Projects, where we do projects and maintenance at home that even an average Joe can accomplish. In today's episode, part two of our bathroom remodel for our kids' bathroom, we're going to go over how I did a little bit of the finish work, and then we did all the shiplap together. Let's do it. Let's start this one off with some motion sickness action, just showing you how far I've gone since the last video. Once the plumbing was done, I went ahead and drywalled over the walls that I had tore down. You can see here that there's some drywall tape that I put between each joint that I'm going to mud over and show you in this project. I used a small hole saw to cut the holes to stick all the plumbing through, and then I'm going to use this pre-mixed joint compound to cover up all the joints and the tape so that the drywall will actually look like the wall is complete. Bear with me, guys. This is not something I'm very good at. I've never really done it more than just patching a hole, so I'm not even using the right tool to make this happen. But I'm going to cover it all up with shiplap anyway, so I'm not too concerned about how it's going to look in the end. I just want to seal it up and then sand it so that it's ready to take the shiplap. It takes a lot of joint compound to cover up the joints in a drywall job like this. For any of you guys out there that know how to do joint compound and then even do texture on drywall, you have my utmost respect. Have you ever had an idea that just caused you to marvel at the brilliance of it? Like, for instance, I took these pieces that I cut out with the hole saw to get the valves through the wall on the drywall, and I was like, man, if I just cut out a piece here, I can stick that in there with some joint compound, and I can plug all those holes. Man, that seems like a great idea. Didn't really work out that way. I finished with this first one and jammed it in there, and I was like, wow, that does work good. I just need to add some joint compound, and I'll just start on the next ones. Yeah, thumbs up, Jim. Great idea. Well, here's the problem. As soon as I put the piece of drywall in there with the joint compound, I just pushed it right down to the inside of the wall. It was a complete waste of time. I ended up using joint compound just to fill the hole and make it work. Okay, now that I'm going to do the shiplap, I wanted to show here that I marked the studs in the wall. I used a stud finder to find them, and then I just used a level with a straight edge to draw exactly on the wall where they're at. That way, I know where to nail in the shiplap. How about that plaster work, guys? You can hardly tell that that's where the seam was. So I'm sure you've noticed, I didn't use standard shiplap for this project. It was way too expensive for what I wanted to spend on this bathroom remodel. So I went ahead and used kind of a hack. I went down to the local Home Depot and I actually bought 1/4-inch maple plywood. You're not really supposed to do this, and I could probably get him in trouble, but I slipped the wood guys like 20 bucks, and I asked them if they could rip my plywood into 6-inch wide strips, 8 feet long. It saved me a whole bunch of work ripping those boards into those 8-foot lengths. Thanks a lot, guys, if you're watching the channel. Okay, something I learned really quickly on this one, you don't want to do this alone. When you're putting the boards up against the wall and you're getting ready to nail them in there, you're going to stick nickels between each board. That leaves a little bit of space in there, but the problem is those stupid nickels keep falling out. That's why you need a little bit of help. I also suggest you get your nail gun ready in advance. Alright, now that my beautiful wife is ready with the compressor and the nail gun, I went ahead and put the board up and held the nickels in there so that we could get the spacing right. She's putting a couple nails in at each stud in the wall, and that's going to hold that shiplap in there nicely. Another tip, before we put these boards up, we already primed the edges. We discovered that if you don't prime the edges first, it is really hard to get paint or primer in between those panels after you've mounted them. So after I cut the boards, we would go ahead and put primer on the edges all the way around, and then we would mount them. This board right here went over that section of drywall that I ended up doing a really ugly job of the plaster. I ended up having to sand it extra to get it on there nice and flat. So make sure you sand it before you start putting up the shiplap. As you see here, it started to rain pretty hard that day. Instead of giving up, I just moved my tools up underneath the back patio and decided I was going to continue to work on this no matter what, rain or shine. I'm glad I persevered. I don't have a ton of time off, so when I am off, I like to get things done. Don't give up, even if the weather doesn't cooperate. Sometimes you can still find a way to make things happen. I'm making these shorter cuts here for the panels that are going to go alongside the door as you come in underneath the medicine cabinet. Putting shiplap around outlets and light switches is not super complicated. You just have to back it out a little bit and make space for the shiplap to get underneath the outlet. You need that to happen so that it'll sit flush with the shiplap and not up underneath it. A little safety message here. When you're making small cuts for small pieces of wood, really be careful with your fingers. If you get in a hurry, you can end up losing a finger over this thing. Okay, here's some sloppy subpar camera work, but I wanted to show you guys what it ended up looking like in the end, going up the whole backside and off to the door side of the bathroom right here. Don't forget to put a hole in the shiplap where your light wiring comes through so you can mount your light in your bathroom. Okay, where the shiplap ends in the corner is not a pretty sight. Not every board ends up exactly in a perfect line. To frame it in there, I bought an 1.5-inch vinyl strip. It sort of just kind of goes up against the wall there. I used the nail gun to nail it in, and then just filled the holes with wood filler. This is the corner where the shiplap ended above my shower. We ended up painting it anyway, so it turned out really nice when it was all done. Now it's time to bring in that new vanity. This thing weighed a ton. My wife and I were able to get it in the house, but it was definitely not an easy task, and I would really highly suggest you get a lot of help when moving one of these things. It's awesome that it's all put together and that it's really high quality built with heavy wood and quartz on top, but man, it is really a difficult thing to move. It was too heavy to carry, so we used a furniture mover and my son's skateboard, which I'm pointing out here. We lined the new plumbing up with the holes in the back of the vanity and just slid it back there. Well, don't forget the skateboard. Gotta make sure you get it out of there. Thanks, buddy, for letting us use it. Once in place, I was kind of excited to get the plumbing work done. I wanted to get the faucet in there and get the drain all set up so that the kids could brush their teeth again in their own bathroom instead of mine. Doing a faucet by yourself can be tricky. I'm trying to screw it in from the bottom to tighten it, but the stupid top keeps turning on me. I had to stop and go get a little bit of help from my wife. I just needed her to hold the top and keep that thing centered in the middle of the sink. That way I could tighten the nut on the bottom and make sure that it didn't go anywhere. You can check out one of my previous episodes on Average Joe's Gym's home projects on how to install a bathroom faucet. Once I got both faucets in, it was time to hook up the drain. Now this is not the easiest thing to do. You have to get the fittings in there with the P-trap to make sure that you can get the drain going right and without losing something down the drain that you don't want to lose. I used a flexible snappy trap plastic P-trap kit for both of my drains in this bathroom. They work great. As usual, links are in the description. So here it is, our completed bathroom remodel with shiplap and a new vanity. After we installed the light and got a couple new mirrors, we really enjoy the way this bathroom turned out. It was especially really nice to get the kids out of our bathroom and back into their very own to brush their teeth before bedtime. If you enjoyed this project, please check out our other projects on Average Joe's Gym's Home Projects. And please like and subscribe for future projects.